Like, subscribe and press the bell icon for more videos from PH and Learn. For more videos, download our app from the Play Store. Hello everyone, welcome to the HTML and CSS tutorial by PH and Technology Private Limited. In this tutorial, we are going to learn about the other basic tags that are used to create a website. So we have known about the declaration and the root tag. Now it's time for the other tags. The other two tags are head and body. Just like a human body, the HTML or the website can only have a single head and a single body. Now, what does the head of the HTML do? In the head of the HTML, we store all the information related to the website, and it is not directly displayed on the website, but it is stored on the back end of the website. Now, what information can we store in the back end? First of all, the title of the website, right? Even though it is displayed directly, do we want it on the website or not is our decision. So this can be stored. The title of the website would come inside the head. The styling, the entire styling of the website content would be done in the head. Then about the website, little bit of about what you see in the Google search, little information written about the website is also stored inside the head. Then the fourth thing that is stored is the author's name, the keywords, everything related to the information of the website is stored in the head. So let's just see about the head. So to declare a head, or the head tag goes as the name head, and it is also a paired tag. Now what all do we need to add? Let's just first start with the title. Okay, so the title of the website, so title is also the paired tag. It would give a title to our website. So let's just give it as PHN tutorial, or you can give it anything you want to. So I have saved it. Now when I am saving it, let's just save it on the desktop. So I am saving it as HTML and CSS. Now let's just go on the desktop and see what's there. Now we can see that whatever file name we have saved has appeared on the desktop with an browser icon. So let's just check that thing out, that file on. So we can see that whatever we have put in the title has appeared as the tab name or the heading of our or the title of our website. So this is how we give a title. Now let's just talk about the backend information which we want to store, such as the author name and stuff like that. So the tag we use here is the meta tag. The meta tag actually stands for metadata. Metadata means data of data. Since we are storing the data of our website in here, there are many attributes used. And also, there is no closing of this tag. Now, let's just come to the point that it does not have any closing tag. Okay, that means that it is a single tag, just the opening tag. Now, I just said a word attribute. Now, what is an attribute? Attribute basically is the characteristics of the tag. It is something related to the tag. Now, the other word that comes up when we talk about the tag is the element. Whatever information or the whatever content we store inside the tag is the element of the tag. So, now let's just declare the meta tag. So, the meta tag goes as meta. Now, we need to declare the attribute, that is the characteristics of this tag. So, first we have entered name. Now, whenever we enter attribute, it should be name equals attribute equals to and double quotes. So, now my meta tag has a name. Now, there are two attributes of meta tag. the first one is the name and the second one is the content. So the name, as it suggests, is the whatever we write in the content is the title of it. Like if we write author in this, okay, and then we declare the attribute content and write your name here, okay, right? I am writing PhD technology. And let's just not forget to close this tag, okay? Even though if it is an unpaired tag, it needs a closing. So this is how I declare my meta tag. And using this, I can declare the keywords, the information about my website, everything over here. There are many attributes of the meta tags which we'll come across while creating a website. So this was about the head tag. Let's just meet in the next tutorial and see about the body tag. Till then, keep coding and try exploring. Thank you.
For more videos, download our app from the Play Store.